Hello guys, welcome back. In this lesson, we will continue with our project preparation and setup. I want to show you Prettier, which is an awesome tool for automated code formatting. Many professional developers and companies are using it to make code style unified and to prevent conflicts in code reviews. And how does it work? Well, it's simple. You install Prettier package. Then you create your Prettier configuration file where you set your linting rules. There is a lot of options. I will show you the most important ones, which I use on a daily basis. And then, when anybody clicks on save in his code editor, all lines of code will automatically be formatted according to the Prettier rules. If you want to learn more about Prettier, feel free to go to the Prettier.io website. There is a lot of resources and, of course, full documentation. So let's now go to the editor and let's make it happen. So first, let's open a terminal and we need to install the dependency. So again, npm install Prettier with two T's and hit enter. This one should be pretty fast. And if we look into the package JSON, we should see Prettier here and your version might be different, but that's completely okay. Now we need to close the terminal. And here in the root of the project, we need to create a configuration file. So let's do dot Prettier RC. And when you are using Visual Studio Code, you should see this nice icon here. And here we need to create and JSON. And here we can specify some rules. So the first rule I want to show you is semi. And I want to set it to false. And this rule will disable using semicolons because in modern JavaScript, not many people are using semicolons. So this will automatically remove them in all the code base. But again, if you prefer to use semicolons, feel free to leave it as true. Then I want to create a single quote and I want to set it to true instead of false. Because again, I personally prefer using single quotes by default instead of double quotes. Then I want to set use tabs and set it to true. And also to set the width of the tabs. And I'm gonna leave it as 2 by default. And then I would like to set the bracket spacing and I'm gonna set it to true. And basically what this does is that it will automatically print spaces between brackets in object literals. Then we have arrow parents. And I want to set void. And what this does is it's no need to include parentheses around the so arrow function parameters. But if you prefer to do it, feel free not to use this rule, but me personally, I like to avoid it. And there is one last step I want to show you, and that is a trailing comma. And instead of none, I want to set it to ES5. And what's this about? This will basically print trailing commas whenever possible, when there is a valid ES5 multi-line code. But again, you don't need to use it if you don't like it. But again, this is my personal preparation of Prettier. There is a much more rules. If you want to learn more, again, go to the Prettier.io website and you can learn all about all the configuration steps. But these ones are the most important and most widely used in all the projects. So we can save it. And don't worry, I'm gonna leave this source code in the notes. So we don't need to type it. You can just copy paste it and modify it later. So I think that's all for the Prettier, and in the next video, I'm gonna show you how to set up the intelligent code completion. So see you there.